group of researchers from the University of Texas, the University of Illinois, and the University of Washington have published an article on their website about a new attack they developed called Hertzbleed. Chip manufacturers Intel and AMD have confirmed that their processors are affected by the Hertzbleed attack. This attack is listed in the CVE system as CVE-2022-24436 for Intel and 2022-23823 for AMD. Neither Intel or AMD are releasing patches to fix the problem, claim the researchers on their website. Neither company responded to questions posed by researchers. This analysis is brought to you by our head of security research, Dalibor Gašić. All sources and links are available in the description. Let's dive into this attack. In June 2022, a group of researchers from the University of Texas, University of Illinois, and the University of Washington published an article on their website about a new attack they develop called Hertzbleed. This attack allows attackers to detect variations in the frequency of CPUs using something called dynamic voltage and frequency scaling, or DVFS for short, and steal entire cryptographic keys in that way. DVFS throttles CPUs so they do not go beyond their thermal or performance limits during high workloads. It also reduces power consumption. As the researchers explain on their site, they prove that attacks can be remotely converted into timing attacks via the power side channel. This method can be classified as a hardware attack, which is an attack that exploits security holes or specific vulnerabilities in the hardware. Intel Security Advisory states that all Intel processors are affected by this attack. We have experimentally confirmed that several Intel processors are affected, including desktop and laptop models from the 8th to 11th generation core microarchitecture. AMD Security Advisory states that several of their desktop, mobile, and server processors are affected. We have experimentally confirmed that AMD Ryzen processors are affected, including desktop and laptop models of the Zen 2 and Zen 3 microarchitectures. Other processor manufacturers also implement frequency scaling in their products and have been made aware of Hertzbleed. However, we have not confirmed whether they are affected by Hertzbleed or not. This attack is listed in the CVE system as CVE-2022-24436 for Intel and CVE-2022-23823 for AMD CPUs. Both Intel and AMD have announced that this vulnerability affects their processors and can be exploited with relatively low privileges. Both AMD and Intel have stated that they do not intend to release patches as they believe the attacks are not practical outside of a lab environment. Both Intel and AMD have provided mitigation assistance by explaining that developers can use masking, hiding, or key rotation to protect against performance analyst-based frequency side channel attacks. The researchers also note that they can disable this feature on Intel CPUs with Turbo Boost and AMD CPUs with Turbo Core or Precision Boost, as it is basically DVFS with a user-friendly name. However, keep in mind that this can affect your PC's performance, and Intel stated that the attack is still possible even if you disable this feature. When attacks that watch for changes in chip speeds or frequency were first discovered in the late 1990s, there was a common fix: write code that only used time-invariant instructions, that is, instructions that take the same time to carry out regardless of what data is being processed. This stopped an observer from gaining knowledge that helped them read data, but Hertzbleed can get around that strategy and can be done remotely. Because this attack relies on the normal operation of the chip's features, not a bug, it could prove tricky to fix. The researchers say that a solution would be to turn off the CPU throttling feature on all chips globally, but warn that by doing so would significantly impact performance, and that it may not be possible to fully stop frequency changes on some chips. Did you find value in this video? If so, give us a like and subscribe to our channel for more content. Or drop a comment down below and let us know what attacks you'd like our experts to cover next.